everyone, in this video let's look at the smart features that Vivo V15 Pro has to offer. So there are a lot of smart assistant features that you can utilize to the fullest and enhance your mobile usage. And before I begin this video, if you are new to my channel, don't forget to click on that subscribe button. I have made a lot of different videos about the settings, tips and tricks, hidden settings, all those kind of things in my channel. So make sure you subscribe and watch those videos as well. So guys, in this video let's look at the smart features quickly. Now I'm in settings here, so just as I move to the settings, what you have to do is to scroll down all the way, and here you'll find a bunch of smart features from the Vivo V15 Pro. Now the first one we'll be looking is obviously the smart motion. So there is smart call here, that means if I just enable the smart answer, let's say I have kept the mobile on table. So if I just kept the mobile on table and if any call appears and if I just hold it to my ear, automatically it will start answering. So you don't have to rather swipe to answer the calls. So if you're a person working a lot and you don't want to, you know, just swipe the things, so the mobile does it for yourself and you'll be able to pick up the call without having to swipe with your fingers. The same goes to the smart call. There is smart switch here as well. If you just tap on this one, it will show you what it does. As you can see, smart switch. So again, if you just hold, it will be in hands-free mode. That means speaker gets activated. So there is smart mute as well. If you don't want to receive any incoming calls or notifications, basically do not disturb feature. So smart mute, you can do that. If you just keep it on the table, smart mute feature gets activated. Similarly, there is smart wake. So there are a bunch of different things that you can do. You can use the gestures. For example, if I just use the E to launch browser, let's say draw E to launch browser, what it does is I'm on the lock screen. Now if I just write E here, it should actually launch the browser. There you go, it recognized the thing and already the browser is opened. So that's very nifty feature. Very quickly you can actually switch the apps. The same way goes to all the different things that's available here. Based on your convenience, you can enable which one you like. Let's say I keep this slide downward to take a photo. Now let's say I want to quickly capture picture, quickly take a photo. What I can do is slide down like this and it should be able to capture a picture. So as you can see, it just opens the camera. I am the one to click the picture. So that way you can actually quickly open the camera as well using that feature. So again, this is smart wake. The same goes to the smart call. There is smart turn on and off screen, rise to wake. So if I just place it on the table and if I just pick up the phone, so you can enable the notifications, or rather you can view all the things that's on your phone quickly. Double click to light, so you can use that. Double tap to turn off screen, you can use that. Shake to turn on the flashlight. Of course, this feature has been here for a while. So there is smart remind. So if you have missed anything, if you just pick up the phone, it will remind you of notifications or messages by actually displaying you on the screen. Actually, there is a separate button over here, as you can see. So if you are not using that, I'll show you how to use that. So that separate button, you can actually customize that button. So in order to enable that, what you have to do is settings, go to the Jovi here. Now here there is smart button. Now you can customize this particular button to a lot of different things, such as Google search. Let's say if I just tap once, so the Google search should be open. Just as you can see, quickly you can move to the Google search and search anything that you are looking for and then come back. Not really a lot of customization that you can do to this particular button. Let's say if I just tap on this button and camera gets opened, it would be really helpful, but that's not the thing here. Again, there is image recognizer. If I just double tap, or rather double press this button, so the AI feature gets activated and it actually recognizes the image and shows you based on that. So it helps while you are actually in the camera mode. You can always do these kind of things. Press and hold the AI button. Basically, they call this Jovi smart button as AI button. So you can use it to call the Google Assistant and or rather tap on none. So these are the things you can customize this particular button, which is Jovi's smart button. Jovi's smart scene here. This basically gives the cards. That means based on these kind of things, it will actually suggest you some cards, such as some news or rather other things. If you'll find it on the home screen here, basically these are the information. As you use your mobile day to day more and more, it actually learns how you are using it, what you are using it, and if there are any reminders, if there are any notifications, everything will be appearing here. So today's headlines, to do list. Now I have not connected to the internet, that's why these are empty here. You can always go to the card management settings. You can enable which one you like and which one you don't. So you can disable that. Instantly you have access to so many things. You can always add different kinds of applications here in order to quickly go to that. Let's say you want to clean up the space, you can just tap on this one and it will clean up for you. So this is how you can use this Jovi's smart assistants, or rather smart scene. Similarly, you have the smart camera. Now this smart camera is automatically recognizing the scene and a lot of different things inside the camera. So for that you have to go to the camera over here, and here what you'll find is inside the settings there is AI portrait framing, AI scene identification. So this is basically the same setting that we saw just now. So AI scene identification, if you enable that, so based on the scenes it recognizes and tries to capture nice images for you. Similarly, there is smart split. You can go to that one and use it. So manual screen split. So let's say I'm using these messages and I want to quickly move to the split screen. As you see, you can use this split screen instantly. I can open the file manager. You can move to a different thing here. So how much space you want for which app. So again, if you just take back, it will become normal. So that's how you use the split screen. So this is basically enabled from here. You can always change the things that you want. Let's say you are in landscape mode. You can always keep one little icon for the messages. So instantly you can reply to your messages as well. Again, an added advantage and convenient feature, which is on the Vivo V15 Pro. So these were the smart features that your Vivo V15 Pro gives. If you enjoyed watching this video, hit that like button. Don't forget to share it with your friends. Also, click on the subscribe button. And if you haven't watched other videos about the Vivo V15 Pro, or rather other mobile photography related videos that I have made, make sure you watch that. Yeah, see you all in another one. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.